Yeah, do it. We have to find the coefficient of x to the power 7. X minus 1 over x. To the power of 40. Okay. It's x square. Can you write it on the screen? Okay, yeah, tell me. T minus A R or 8. Why 8? Yeah. After that. Yeah. Equals to what? Yeah. After this. After that. Mm. After that, so we put 2 in 1. So we will put the value of r equals to 11 here. So we get t11 equals to 40c. Sorry, it will be 12. Correct? 12. Then x the power of how much? I can put it here, right? It's better. So minus 1 to the power of 11 x the power 30th. How much is that? 7. Okay, so minus 40c11 into x the power. Now so what is the answer? What have they asked in the question? So what is the coefficient? Yeah, minus 40c11. Yeah, coefficient means the term attached to that. So we'll accept x the power 7. The remaining thing. So coefficient of x to the power 7 is minus 40 c 11. Okay, so have you copied it? Kal, then so we'll go to the next question. Same, I'm not writing the whole thing. Coefficient of x to the power minus 15 in 3x square minus a over 3x cube. Okay, so yeah, Well, right, right. 3x square minus a over 3x cube. Okay. Thank you. Did you say something? So where are you? You can write it. Can you write on the board? Yeah. Can you tell me the steps? What is the first? No, minus a over 3x cube. We'll take x term separate and the constant term separate. So it will be minus a to the power r . So it's a general thing which will follow in all the questions, that you will take x term separate and the other constant terms separate, like a and 3 separate. So why, first of all, why we are doing it? Because we want minus 15, so that we take x term separate and we can take the power equated to minus 15. So, and now we can see that in constant terms also there are 2, a and 3. So a will take separate and 3 will take separate. 3 to the power 10 minus r minus r, so it will be 10 minus 2 r. Correct? You got it? No, did you get how I got 10 minus 2r? 10 minus r and minus r. Okay, and x to the power, you tell me what will be x to the power. I will not tell, you should tell. See, 2 multiply by 10 minus r, what will be 2? 20 minus 2r, 20 minus, and then minus 3r. Perfect, very good. So 20 minus 5r. Now what will be the next step? So this will equate to, correct. No, no. This will come here, this will come there. So 20 plus 15. Twenty and 15 is 35, right? So R equals to 7. So R is 7. So what will be the next step? Yes, not original, this one, which we have simplified. So so what will be the coefficient? I can write minus 10c7 a to the power 7 and over 3 to the power 4. Understand? You can copy this. Done. So just okay, I'll give some questions as homework and maybe you can do one question here. Okay, because you don't get time for doing homework. So I think you don't. Right. Coefficients of find coefficient. Yes. Okay. So you're there, Ramin? So let me explain you how we'll do each and every type of question. So it's same concept. So first question is easy. We have been doing so far. Okay, same method. Second question is also the same method. Only thing is, instead of numbers, you are given M and N. Okay, so same thing, if you follow the same step. Now third question is little different. How we do third question is that first of all, the question says x means x the power 1, correct? So we want x the power 1. So what are the different possibilities? See, this is x the power 0, correct? 1 can be written as x the power 0. This is x the power 1. This is x the power 2. So so let me think for each and everything. What should be multiplied by x the power 1 to get x the power 1? It means I should have the first coefficient here should be x the power 0, correct? Or simply the first term 1, correct? Multiply, and then what should be multiplied by x the power 1? I want x the power 0 should be multiplied by x the power 1, correct? To get x the power 0 into x the power 1. Now x the power 1, what should I multiply x the power 1 with to get x the power 1? Simply I should multiply by 1, correct? Or x the power 0. You understanding? Really? I'll multiply this by this, x the power 0 by x the power 1, x the power 1 by x the power 0, or simply 1. Now third, what should I multiply x square with? Can you tell me what should I multiply x so that I can get x? Perfect, very perfect. X the power minus 1, very good. That means 1 over x, correct? So when I multiply x square with 1 over x, 1 by x, so I get x. So these two will form a couple. So basically, and the question says find the coefficient, correct? Find the coefficient. So how will I get coefficient? So I will multiply this coefficient with this coefficient. Okay, you getting? So there will be three cases. So let me solve it here itself. So there will be case 1. Case 1, x the power 0 into x the power 1, correct? So I will find out the coefficient of x the power 0 in first binomial and the coefficient of x the power 1 in second binomial, and I'll multiply them, correct? So in first binomial it's clear, quite obvious, the coefficient is 1. And the second binomial, what is the coefficient of x the power 1? If I want x the power 1, I should take 16c2 minus x the power, if you want to write directly, minus 1d power 2 or x the power 2, but I don't want to write x because I am writing coefficients. So this will be the answer. So directly I can write 16c2. Did you understand? Sure. So can you note it down? And can you do the remaining case 2 and case 3 and just add all? Okay.
Then then, so can you tell me the answer orally? What do you get? Can you write it on the board? Thank you. Yeah, tell me. No, I am talking about this question. This question is not completed. Third question. So just see here. In this question, we need x the power 1. So x the power 1 can be got by various ways. So when I multiply this x the 1 with x the power 1, when I multiply x with x square, sorry, not x square. When I multiply x with 1, or when I multiply x square with 1 by x. Okay, there are three ways. So case 1, I got the coefficient from the second one. Okay. Now case 2, I will get -3. I will multiply the coefficient of both. -3 is the coefficient of here, x, and here I need 1. So I know the first term will be 1. First term will be 1. So I'll multiply by 3 and up. So I get -3. For case 2, I'll get. Understood? So for case 2, it will be x the power 1 into x the power 0. So the coefficient will be -3 into 1, because the first term will be 1. So answer is -3. Now case 3, we'll add all the three, case 1, case 2 and case 3. Case 3, we want x the power 1, right? So it is x square. We'll multiply x square with 1 by x. Okay. So first term, in the first expansion, we can see that x coefficient is 7. In the second expansion, you have to find out. So 7 into, what will be the coefficient of -1? When will I get that -1? Sorry, x the power -1. When will I get x the power -1? So there is no coefficient of x the power -1, right? Hello. So in this
in the second expansion, the coefficient of x will go from xz power 0 to xz power 16, correct? So there is no term with xz power minus 1, correct? So that was the trick. So there will not be the third part, there will only be first and second cases. So we'll just add them, 16c2 and minus 3. So I can write here not possible or does not exist. So the coefficient of x is 16c2 minus 3. We can find out 16c2. Understood? Did you understand? Okay, so I think time is up. Okay, you can practice the questions.